many experiences which I can share where people have come out from failure. We all have heard from the school days the story of Thomas Edison. I mean, the fact that he never gave up, and we should be thanking the electricity for it, for what he has done. One of the biggest entrepreneurs and one of the biggest motor company ever there, Ford. So Henry Ford is another one which never gave up. For a lot of people in Asia who love Jack Ma, remember he was rejected by even a person serving, he served as a person in a restaurant. So this is an amazing people who have never given up on the fact that they didn't start up very well. They had their drawbacks, they have their limitations, and they overcome them. I do not know how many people have watched, but it's one of my all-time favorite movies. And frankly speaking, if you haven't watched it, I would please ask you to watch it post the show. It is a movie called Pursuit of Happiness. It is a real story of Gardner. It's one very beautiful movie made, and Will Smith is the actor there. And he has beautifully got the entire thing, and he is an insurance guy who cannot have or does not have the means to even feed his own family. And the way he comes across, and at the end when he starts the success, the tears which comes out, and he has gone through the entire failures, is we all learn from it. Trust me, whenever I'm down and out, and there are days, in spite of fact, Dr. Kelly has introduced me and I have good ranking behind me, but there are days when even I have failed. So whenever I'm down and out, I love one movie, which is one of my all-time favorite. And I'm sure a lot of people have watched it. It's the Rocky series, Rocky Balboa. It tells you it doesn't matter what happens when you get down. It matters whether are you getting up. And that's the story Rocky Saga teaches us. And that is why it was one of the biggest hits. And it's a true story of a guy who actually fought with Muhammad Ali, and he could take him to last rounds. And this inspired Sylvester Stallone to set up. So Stallone's success story is also like that. He was born in New York's Hell's Kitchen. Virtually with everything, he gave it away. He was not ready to, in fact, sacrifice his story. It was the last one they wanted to pick it up. And they then picked up the story, then deciding that he will not be an actor. Remember, he stammers also a lot. But he was very perseverant that if this movie, I'll sell the script, I want to be an actor. One of the studios decided that they had made a lot of money that year, so they don't mind taking a gamble. And in fact, they wanted it to show the loss-making unit. So see how the story has developed. And this became all-time favorite hit and one of the favorite hits for people who love boxing. And it's inspired a lot of people. In fact, if you ever go to US, if you go to Philadelphia, you'll see a lot of people, running around the street to do the exact action as Rocky. And that captured the image of everybody. And when you talk of failure, the biggest success story 2 days back is a team which didn't qualify for the World Cup last year. Look at Italy. I mean, what a turnaround. I mean, they didn't qualify for the World Cup. And remember, Europeans, they take football very seriously. Imagine they were virtually, it's a national disgrace for them that they don't qualify. For them to come out 34 matches unbeaten under a new coach, and nobody gave Italy a lot of scope. If you're looking at it, the favorites were France, followed by Germany, followed by a lot of teams. In fact, even in the finals, England were the hot favorites. The entire Latin workers had made a lot of money on England. But Italy broke all of them. They had the self-belief that nothing is stopping us. If you look at entire coaches and everything, and even if you look at the team, it's not one single player who was in the forefront. Everybody contributed a lot. And that's how success story comes in. When you believe that it is possible. And how do you believe it? It's, first of all, the failure which sets you back. There are two things which can happen from the failure. Either you go down and out, or you learn from it. And this is the biggest lesson. Keep in mind, all of us who are there in the platform, who are watching us live, or even in future, we will fail. It is inevitable. What matters is, what have you done with your failure? Have you gone back, introspected where you went wrong, and then come across? Or you've gone in the shell? That attitude will take you the next step. Second, failure makes you to go deeper. You will research, you will understand what went wrong. My fellow colleague Dr. Seema has brilliantly explained about Steve Jobs. Imagine starting your own company, getting thrown out, and then you come back again. Another example is Walt Disney. Please watch a movie, Disney. It took 10 years for Disney to become what Disney is all about. It will tell you all his struggles which he has done before Mickey Mouse became a popular saga. So there's no person who can tell you that he has come to this stage without achieving failure. He has got it. It's the learning process. Tendulkar won his World Cup in the fifth attempt. He might be the brilliant genius we had, but in the fifth attempt, he has won the World Cup. So there's nobody who's got it at the very first stage. You might be luckier, but most of us have failed and gone back and introspected. Second, it makes you mentally very stronger. When you fail, you will come back very stronger. It's very important that you take it with a very positive thing. Don't go back and see what went wrong. Think what could have been done better. It's very important. To be honest with you, I think even English team should be very proud that 55 years later, they made it into the final. Last year, they went to semis. So maybe the next World Cup, they might actually win the cup. So it's going in the right direction. And one of the players who's won the 20th slam, look at Djokovic. He came in the era which is surrounded by Federer and Nadal. What a scenario he had. I mean, most of the slam finals, he was getting knocked out by both Federer and as well as Nadal. And to think on it, he has taken around 6-7 attempts to understand where he's going on. And mentally, right now, I think he's the strongest among all the three. And there's a huge probability he might break the record. If you're looking at it, he started a bit later than both of them. And that's because he's mentally very fit. He's more stronger than both of them. And that's the reason why I reckon. Because he's known what his failure is. He has understood and gone back and worked on it. Then, biggest thing is, when you get success, sometimes you do not know what to do with the success. Success is a very lousy teacher because it makes you think that you are too brilliant. The biggest example, and in my heyday, we had one of the favorite all-time sports person, Boris Becker. He was called as the Boom Boom Becker. At 17, he won Wimbledon when nobody had ever won it. He was the first non-ranked person to win it, and he won it very next year. It went into his head. He did not know what to do it because it was so easy for him to do it. For a lot of people who think Sachin Tendulkar is a genius, it's a lot of amount of hard work. For a lot of Indians who are watching it, along with Sachin, there was another talented guy named Vinod Kambli. And Vinod Kambli, to a lot of people, was more talented than Sachin Tendulkar. But for Vinod Kambli, the success came too early. First time it happened in Wankhede Stadium, Courtney Walsh just started him bouncing him back. He just started giving him bouncers. And Vinod Kambli has till that time never had any roadblocks. And he couldn't handle it. That was the last time he ever played test cricket for India. He didn't know what to do with the failure because he's never encountered it. To all people who watch sports, do you think any of the people who play at the highest level, like an Indian team or a Bangladesh cricket team or anybody who plays at the highest level will not have any skills? It's not the skills they have. It is the attitude which they have and they learn from it. That's very important. The learning part is the way it will take you ahead. Failures will make you take things or chances which you have never thought it could do. I also tell my students when they appear for entrance, don't think it's a roadblock. This is how life will be. You'll have to take a gamble. You'll have to decide which is a better bet and that will work in your favor. You think what is important? How do you handle this crisis? How you take it? In life, you will not be able to get it. So the same way entrance prepares you for that. And the biggest thing, failures will make you have more empathy towards your fellow colleagues. Because once you have understood failures, you'll realize how life changes to you. Suddenly, the friends are no longer friends. The relatives divert. The same people who were with you will show you other way around. And sometimes, it's a big slap you need it sometimes. It involves you to come ahead, be stronger, be mentally very fit now to overcome the next step. And the biggest one, nothing tastes success more than after you had failure. Because once you had a failure, you will enjoy success. If success had come very, very easily to you, you will still not enjoy it. But if you have failed and achieved this, you can see any sports person, any movie star who achieved a stardom after tons of failures, the success is what they did. And they then will remain more humbled and grounded. So there are umpteen examples. I can tell you so many of them. I'm sure everyone here will have his own story. I have started my career in teaching, but in the very first day when I was started teaching, I, being a good student, started teaching at the very difficult level. I went and told the counselor, okay, listen, I've taught them all important sums and they'll be enjoying it. But unfortunately, when the counselor went and spoke to the students, they said he's an average teacher. We didn't understand anything because I didn't understand that if I want to go to the level, I'll have to go to the ground root level. I took it back, understood my failure, accepted it. For 1 month, I started preparing, and then I came out, and then the history is, I mean, the history is rewritten. So every person...